Morning students and welcome to today's maths class. So in the previous class we finished with the second chapter, that was addition. So we saw various methods of addition, then we saw how to add four digit numbers with regrouping and without regrouping, right? Then we also saw how to solve word problems. Now in today's class we'll be starting with your third chapter, that is called subtraction. So your third chapter is subtraction. So what is subtraction? Subtraction means to take away something. Okay, it means to take away something. Now here subtraction means to take away. Okay, see, we always subtract a smaller number from a larger number. So when you're writing numbers during subtraction, you write the larger number first, then write the smaller number, because we always subtract a smaller number from a larger number. And the result of a subtraction is called a difference. So when you subtract two numbers, the answer that you get is called a difference. It is called difference. Okay, and subtraction is signified by the minus sign. So this is the symbol you use to show subtraction. Okay, so this is basically what is subtraction. Now what we'll do is we'll do a quick warm-up activity on what you have already studied about subtraction in your second standard, and then we'll move on to the further topics. So page number 106 in your textbooks. So the third chapter, that is subtraction. Now here question number 1 in warm-up, they have told complete the following by observing the pattern. Okay, so first here see, now we have first example they have done for us. They have done 25 plus 3 is equal to 28. And here on the other side of the table they have given 28 minus 3 is equal to 25. So when you add two numbers, now they are adding 25 plus 3. How much is it? It is 28. Okay, but among these three numbers only they have done subtraction also. So when you do 28 minus 3, you will get 25. So if you do 28 minus 25, you'll get 3. Okay, so this is how you do it. First, let us complete the first column. Okay, so 100 plus 40. How much is 100 plus 40? 100 plus 40 is 140. Now here they've told 140 minus 40. So here we have 140, 140. 100 plus 40 is 140. So 140 minus 40 will be how much? Which is the remaining third number here? It is called 100. So this is a 100. Okay, 140 minus 40 is 100. Then 250 plus 45. So how much you'll get when you add 250 plus 45? Add and see what you'll get. You will get 295. Okay, you get 295. Now when you do 295 minus 45, what will you get? You'll get the remaining number, that is 250. Okay, so 295 minus 45 will be 250. Now you see these three numbers which you're adding and subtracting, they're all related. So when you do 250 plus 45, you get 295. When you do 295 minus 45, you get 250. Same way, if you do 295 minus 250, you'll get 45. Okay, so there's three numbers which you're adding and subtracting, they're all interrelated. So when numbers are related like this by addition and subtraction, then these numbers are called fact families. It's not there in your book, it is just an extra fact for y'all, that these numbers are called fact families. Okay, now 310 plus 3 plus 22. So when I add 310 plus 22, what will I get? I'll get 332. Okay, 332. Now they have asked here dash minus 22 is equal to dash. Now you can put either way. You can either put 332 minus 22 is equal to 310, or you can also put 310. Yeah, so it will be 332 minus 22 is equal to 310. Alright, so this is your D answer. Now question number E, 400 plus 90. How much is 400 plus 90? It is 490. Now here they have told dash minus 400. Since the first number should always be a larger number, it will be 490 minus 400 is equal to 90. Okay, 490 minus 400 is 90. Now they have told 327 plus 63. So how much is 327 plus 63? It is 390. Okay, it is 390. Now dash minus 327. So always you subtract a smaller number from a larger number. So 390 minus 327, which will be 63. You don't have to calculate. If you see how the numbers are related, you can answer the questions. Okay. So this was question number 1. Now moving on to question number 2. Find the difference between the largest 2-digit number and the smallest 1-digit number. So they have already done that. That is 99 minus 1 is equal to 98. Okay, now question 2. The smallest 3-digit number and the largest 2-digit number. So how much is the smallest 3-digit number? It is 100. And then what is the largest 2-digit number? It is 99. So you have to find the difference. So that is 100 minus 99. Okay, it is 100 minus 99, which is equal to 1. 100 minus 99 is 1. Okay, so copy that down. Then question C, the largest 3-digit number and the largest 1-digit number. Now how much is the largest 3-digit number? The largest 3-digit number is 999. Okay, so it is 999. Then and the largest 1-digit number, so 999 minus 9. Okay, so that will be equal to 990. All right, then next one, the largest 3-digit number and the largest 2-digit number. Largest 3-digit number again is 999 and largest 2-digit number is 99. So 999 minus 99 will give you 900. Okay, then the last question, the largest 3-digit number 999 again minus the smallest 3-digit number, which is 100. So that will give you 899. Okay, so last answer is 899. All right, so complete question number 2. Then we'll move on to question number 3. So here question number 3, first one is 10 minus 9. What is 10 minus 9? Sorry, 10 minus 1. So 10 minus 1 is equal to 9. Okay, 10 minus 1 is 9. Then 10 minus 2. How much will be 10 minus 2? It will be 8. And then 10 minus 3 is 7. Okay, so 9, 8, 7. Then 40 minus 1. How much will be 40 minus 1? It will be 39. Then 50 minus 2. How much is 50 minus 2? It is 48. And then 60 minus 3 will be 57. Okay, so 39, 48 and 57. Then 59 is equal to dash minus 1. So how much minus 1 you will get 59? You will get 60 minus 1 as 59. Same here. 78 is equal to dash minus 2. So that will be 80 minus 2 is equal to 78. Then 67 is equal to dash minus 3. So that will be 70 minus 3 is equal to 67. Okay. Then next one. Dash is equal to 30 minus 1. How much is 30 minus 1? 30 minus 1 will be 29. Then 20 minus 2 is how much? 20 minus 2 will be 18. And 100 minus 3 is equal to dash. So how much is 100 minus 3? It will be 97. Okay. So 29, 18 and 97 are the answers for question number 3D. Alright. Now moving on to question number 4. Now question number 4. First we'll do 8 minus 4. How much will be 8 minus 4? 8 minus 4 is 4 only. So you write 4 there. Then 4 minus 3, how much is 4 minus 3? 4 minus 3 is 1 and 6 minus 2 is 4. So your first answer is 4, 1, 4. Then 9 minus 5, how much is 9 minus 5? 9 minus 5 is 4. Then again 9 minus 5 is there, which is 4 only. And then 7 minus 3, how much is 7 minus 3? 7 minus 3 is also 4. So answer is 444. Then 7 minus 2, can you calculate how much is 7 minus 5? It is 7 minus 5 is 2. Then 6 minus 4, now again 6 minus 4 will be 2 itself. And then 5 minus 1 is 4. So your answer is 422. Okay, so first answer is 414, the next answer is 444, and the last one is 422. Okay, so this was a quick warm-up on what you'll have studied in subtraction in second standard. Now what we'll do is, we'll see the next part, that is subtraction on number line. So subtraction on a number line. So how do you do subtraction using number line? Now 4 minus 2 is equal to 2 therefore. So you have a number line with the number 0 to 10 over here. So you first, now among 4 and 2, you see which is the smallest number. Among 4 and 2, the smallest number is 2. So you circle 2 and then you take steps towards 4. Now here from 2 to go to 4, how many steps you need? You take 1 and then 2 steps. So you're reaching 4 in 2 steps. So you're counting forward from 2 to go to 4. So we went ahead by 2 steps. So 4 minus 2 will be 2. Okay, so this is a simple subtraction on using number line for a 1 digit. Now let us see subtraction using number line for 2 digit numbers. Now here, subtract 23 from 55. Now as I told, always counting forward from 23. So you can always see the smallest number among the given numbers. So 23 is smaller than 55. So we'll start from 23. And since 55 is far away, what we'll do is, we'll count from 23 in steps of 10. So 23 plus 10, that is a step of 10 will be 33. Then again, one more step of 10 will be 43. Then 53. Now here 53 is quite nearby to 50, so we can't take a step of 10 ahead. So what you'll do, see how many steps are there between 53 and 55. So you'll have 54 and 55, two steps. So we'll have two steps from 53 to 55. Okay, so now we counted forward from 23 to 53 in tens by three steps and by ones in two steps. So we did 3 tens plus 2 ones, which is 32. So 55 minus 23 is equal to 32. Another example, subtract 428 from 476. Okay, now from we start from 428 and again we are taking steps of 10. So 428 to 438. Okay, then 438 to 448. Then from 448 to 458, then from 458 to 468, and then what you can do is, you can take 468 to 478, because there's a big difference between 468 to 476, so we'll avoid counting in ones. We'll go from 468 to 478, okay, which is nearby to 476. Now from 478 is greater than 476, correct, which is our required number. So what we'll do, we will go back two steps to 476 from 478. Okay, counting forward from 428 in steps of 10, we reach 478 in 5 steps. That is here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, as 476 is slightly less than 478, we count backwards 2 steps from 478. Okay, in ones to reach 476. So we have 5 tens. So we took 5 ten steps. So 5 tens minus 2 ones, because we went backwards from 478 to 476. So minus 2 ones. So 5 tens minus 2 ones will be 50 minus 2, which is 48. Okay, so for 476 minus 428 is equal to 48. Alright, so this is how you do subtraction on a number line. Now let's see a few properties of subtraction. First property is subtracting 0. When 0 is subtracted from a number, the result is the number itself. So whenever you subtract 0 from any number, you get the difference as the number itself. So see the example here, 512 minus 0. So 512 minus 0 will be 512. Okay. And then subtracting itself. So whenever a number is subtracted from itself, the result is 0. So 725 minus 725 will be 0 only. Then subtracting 1. When 1 is subtracted from a number, we get its predecessor. Okay, when we know that when we add 1 to a number, we get its successor. Same way, when you subtract 1 from a number, you get its predecessor. So, 693 minus 1 gives you 692. Okay, so these are the various properties of subtraction. Now, let's see a few questions on subtraction using number line. Okay, so page number 108, exercise 3.1. So first question, subtract 78 on the number line. Okay, subtract on number line. So first one is 78 minus 25. So which is the smaller number here? So the smaller number here is 25. So just circle 25 like this. Then from 25, okay, let's count in tens. We'll count forward in tens. So we are moving 25 to 35, 35 to 45, 45 to 55, 55 to 65, and 65 to 75. Now 75 is nearer to 78. So what we'll do? We'll count in ones. So when you count in ones from 75 to 78, you count it in threes. Okay, that is, you'll count 3 ones. So here we have the answer as, now how many steps of 10 did we take? We took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is 5 tens. So we have 5 tens plus how many ones? 3 ones. Okay, so how much is that? That is 50. So 78 minus 25 will be 53. Okay. So that is the first question. Now second question. 82 minus 38. So we start from 38. Okay. 38 to 48 counting forward in tens. 48 to 58. 58 to 68. And 68 to 78. 78 is nearer to 82. So what we'll do now? We'll count in ones. So when you count in ones and reach 82, you'll count by 4 ones. Okay, so here the answer will be, see, by how many steps are we jumping for tens? We're taking 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 tens plus 4 ones. So 82 minus 38 is 44. Okay, 82 minus 38 is 44. Now 489 minus 427. So start with 427 and count forward in tens first. So this is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Okay, so we reached 487. Right, now what we'll do is from 487 to 489, we'll count in ones. So when you count in ones, you will count 2 ones. So that is 2 here. So we have how many tens? How many tens did we count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that is 6 tens plus how many ones is it? It is 2 ones. So 6 plus 2 ones is equal to 62. So 489 minus 427 is 62. Okay. Then the last question, 327 minus 249. So we'll start from 249 and count forward in tens. So this is 110, this is 2 tens, 3 tens, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then here we'll go to 329. Okay, that is 8 tens. Now here 327 is smaller than 329. So we'll count backwards from 329 to 327. Okay, so how many steps we counted backwards? We counted 2 steps backwards. Alright, so how will you write this? You'll write this as how many tens did we count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that is 8 tens minus 2 ones. So how much is 8 tens minus 2 ones? That is 80 minus 2 is 78. So your answer is 78. 327 minus 249 is 78. Okay, so this is how you do subtraction on the number line. Now question E and F for you is for your homework. Okay, so complete that for your homework and come, and we'll continue with subtraction in the next class. Okay, we'll continue with subtraction in the next class. All right, thank you, students.